have become very comfortable and content and doing the same thing over and over again. We're like, oh, I feel like this is purposeless now, and I'm just going through the motions, blah, blah, blah. No, no, you need to stay faithful in that and know that God can provide new instructions to you at a drop of a whim. Like, you don't stop receiving instruction from the Lord literally until you die and on this earth. So I just wanted to go into that a little bit more about, literally, it starts from even our conception. It starts from even when we were newborns. Like, we had purpose then. So our purpose then was to eat, sleep, absorb sound, shape, colors. And that was a process. It was a process of all that. It was development. And even now, as we fast forward to where we are right now, it's still a process. So the menial things that we feel like aren't important, the menial things that we feel like the Lord is, when he tells us to get to our jobs on time, or, you know, reach out to our sister about something, or just even being mindful to how we treat friends and family members, our own parents, that is purposeful. And those little small things, they build on a lifetime of purpose. So if you start thinking about purpose in that way, that's still purposeful. We often don't see it this way because we often assume that purpose equals something grandiose. Many women follow us in the same capacity because of being known. We think that to be purposeful, we need to be known. We need to be popular on social media. We need to have all these likes. That's not purpose. Purpose is being obedient to the Lord right now.
Amen.
I'm jumping to a whole point. It's the truth. Purpose is being obedient right now. Something I wrote, the great purpose in your life is being obedient to God's instructions and living a life for Him. Like, do we even comprehend that? Us being obedient to God is purposeful to God. So we need to start weighing, do we feel like we're being purposeful for ourselves? Are we living purpose for ourselves, for attention, for a big stage, for, you know, our own self-edification? Are we truly being obedient to God and being purposeful in His sight? We have refused to humble ourselves and get to know God for our now. Like, we need to gain more humility. I think that if we actually submit unto God, we will see purpose His way. And a lot of us are committed to ourselves. We are submitted to our fleshly ways. We are submitted to what mother says, what our boss says, what our professors say, all of these other people, instead of being submitted unto God. So we have to, it's almost like a mindset change that has to happen. It is a mindset change that has to happen in order for us to do it God's way and actually stick with it. We can't continue on in those same ways thinking that that's the way that we live in our purpose, or in the way of the world. No, we need to live in a kingdom way. So as I talked about purpose being based on obedience to God's word, it starts there, being obedient to God's word. Then what the other things He might be telling me to do on top of that, and then also being consistent and obedient in the last thing He's told you to do. So for example, if you, like, quite a few of the women throw their hands up when I ask them, they become perfect. The thing is, to start out with even knowing your worth and knowing who you are in Christ, you're going to have to pray and open up your word. It's going to have to start there. Some of the books